Please be seated.
好，我们现在来看一节哈，《生命记》的第五章。
Let's read Deuteronomy chapter 5.
生命记第五章。
Deuteronomy chapter 5.
第五节。
Chapter 5, verse 5.
请读。
5, verse 5. I stood between the Lord and you at that time to declare to you the word of the Lord, for you were afraid because of the fire, and you did not go up to the mountain, he said.
这里摩西在讲哈，那时我站在神跟你们中间。
Moses said, at that time I stood before you and God.
其实我们在服侍神哈，其实就是站在神跟人中间。
So actually, when we do the work of servitude, we are standing before God and man. Between God and man.
Yeah. 我们要站在人的面前代表神。
We had to stand before man to represent God.
好像摩西站在以色列百姓面前代表神传达神的话。
Just like how Moses stood before the people of Israelites and to give the words and to speak on behalf of God.
那传达神要叫他们做什么。
And to preach the instructions of God.
在从另一方面来说，摩西要站在神的面前代表以色列百姓。
Another perspective, Moses has to stand before God to represent the people of Israel.
求神赦免以色列百姓。
To ask God to forgive the people of Israel.
求神照顾以色列百姓。
To ask God to guide, to look after the people of Israel.
好像他们没有水喝啊，在埋怨啊，他要站在神的面前来求神带领。
Just when they at the time when they don't have water and complain, he has to stand before God.
所以服侍神就是站在神跟人中间的工作。
So when we serve, it is the work that we are standing between God and man.
那我们在摩西跟约书亚的服侍里面可以看到很重要，就是他们站在人面前代表神的时候，人可以接受。
And one of the important things that we see in the servitude of Moses and Joshua is that when they are representing God and stand before men, people are able to accept.
他们站在神面前代表人的时候，神可以接受。
And when they are standing before God to represent men, God is also able to accept.
所以这个工作就做得好。
Then this is a good job well done.
如果站在人面前代表神，人不能接受，那你神的话就传不下去了。
If they are standing before men to represent God and they cannot pass on the instruction, then the work cannot be done.
那如果站在神面前代表人，神不能接受，那他所带领这些以色列百姓都死光了。
And similarly, if they are standing before God to represent men and God did not accept it, then God's wrath would have killed all the people of Israel.
那怎么让两边都能接受？这个就是灵修啊。
It will be upon our spiritual cultivation to allow both sides to accept.
那我们先来看为什么以色列人会听从他。
So now let's read how come the Israelites is willing to listen to them.
首先我们来看为什么以色列百姓会听从摩西。
So let's first read how come the Israelites are willing to listen to Moses.
出埃及记第四章。
Exodus chapter 4.
第四章第一节。
Exodus chapter 4 verse 1.
摩西回答说，他们不信我，也不听从我的话，必说神没有向你显现。
4 verse 1. Then Moses answered and said, But suppose they will not believe me or listen to my voice. Suppose they say the Lord has not appeared to you.
这个地方摩西也知道说他不听我怎么办。
So Moses also know what happens if the people does not listen to me.
到最后就是第四节最后那个手中的杖。
So that is why the staff in his hand in verse 4.
那就是神给他的权柄。
This is the authority given to him by God.
所以神以色列百姓就听从他了。
That is why the people of Israel listened to them.
那到申命记的三十四章。
Now let's turn to Deuteronomy chapter 34.
34章的第九节。
34 verse 9.
我们刚刚有 提过啊，读过。
We have mentioned it already, 34:9.
这里说，摩西按手在他头上，被圣灵充满，以色列人便听从他。
For here it says, Now Joshua the son of Nun was full of the spirit of wisdom, for Moses has laid his hand on him, so the children of Israel heeded him.
所以以色列百姓听从约书亚是因为他被圣灵充满。
So the people of Israel heeded Joshua because he is filled by the Spirit.
也就是说他有神同在啊。
Because he has the abidance of God.
所以敬畏神的人都听从他。
So those who feared God obeyed him.
所以今天我们在服侍神。
So today when we serve God,
其实，在教会里面呢，就是很简单的，神与我们同在，我们就信徒就容易来顺从我们的带领。
It'll be very simple if God is with us, then the believers will heed our leadership.
所以这个追求神的同在，变成这是最重要一件事情了。
So pursuing the abidance of God, this is our most important task.
追求神的同在就是被圣灵充满。
And pursuing the abidance of God means that we have to pursue the fullness of Holy Spirit.
然后照神的话来做。
And then we do things according to the word of God.
那这样神就跟我们同在。
Then God shall be with us.
所以如果信徒能够来听从我们的带领，我们圣公才有办法推动。
And then it is when the believers have heeded our leadership, then we can push forward with the holy work.
那如果不听，怎么带领？
If they do not heed us, then how can we lead?
所以我们就从这里可以学到要神同在。
So that's why we learn here we need the abidance of God.
那我们要为信徒代祷。
And we also had to pray for the believers.
那信徒的问题，神愿意接纳，我们信徒的问题才会解决。
And it is after that God has accepted, then He will help solve the problems of the believers.
那怎么让我们的祷告能够被神接纳？
How can we allow our prayers to be accepted by God?
那我们现在来看，出埃及记33章。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 33.
32章。
32.
我们看31节跟32节。
Verse 31 and 32. 31, Then Moses returned to the Lord and said, O, these people have committed a great sin and have made for themselves a god of gold. 32, Yet now if you will forgive their sin, but if not, I pray, blot me out of your book which you have written.
在前面这一段里面，我看到神非常生气，甚至说要灭绝他们。
In the previous passage, we learned that God is very angry and that He wanted to destroy the people of Israel.
但是通过摩西的祷告,
but through the prayer of Moses,
后来神就赦免他们,
that then God forgave them.
所以神继续带领他们,
and then God continued to let them.
所以这里就告诉我们说, 我们爱心的祷告,这非常重要。
So here it teaches us the prayer of love is very important.
这是第四点,
That's the fourth point.
因为按手,所以他被智慧的灵充满。
Because Moses laid hand on him, he was filled by the spirit of wisdom.
我们看民数记27章。
Let's turn to Numbers chapter 27.
民数记27章。
Numbers 27.
们来看二十三节。
23, and he laid his hand on him and inaugurated him, just as the Lord commanded by the hand of Moses.
那在我们刚刚读生命记的三十四章第九节。
In Deuteronomy chapter 34, verse 9.
好，说摩西按手在头上，他就被智慧的灵听充满，以色列人听从他。
After Moses had laid on him, he was filled by the spirit of wisdom, and the people of Israel heeded him.
哦，这里讲哈。
And there is said.
他被圣灵充满。
He was filled by the Holy Spirit.
就是智慧的灵。
The spirit of wisdom.
以色列人便听从他。
Then the people of Israel heeded him.
哦，所以，哦，充满属灵的智慧。
So when we are filled by the spiritual wisdom.
哦，这是我们在服事神一个很重要的条件。
This is one of our great important criteria when we serve God.
在雅各书里面，让我们来看两种智慧。
In the book of James, let's look at two types of wisdom.
雅各书第三章。
The book of James, chapter 3.
Verse 13,
who is wise and understanding among you, let him show by good conduct that his work are done in the meekness of wisdom.
这里讲了，这个智上头的智慧是温柔的。
So the wisdom from above is meekness, gentleness.
然后十四节。
Verse 14.
怀着苦毒的嫉妒纷争，就不可自夸，也不可说谎话，抵挡真道。
14. But if you have bitter envy and self-seeking in your heart, do not boast and lie against the truth.
所以这个地上的智慧常常带给人是嫉妒纷争。
So the worldly wisdom often bring envy and fight.
然后自夸然后说谎，抵挡真道。
And it will bring boast and lies against the truth.
十六节。
16.
何处有嫉妒纷争，就何处有扰乱和各样的坏事。
For where envy and self-seeking exist, confusion and every evil things are done.
所以有时候我们从一个人的表现就可以看出这是。从神来的智慧还是地上的。
So if we observe someone's conduct, then we will know whether or not his wisdom comes from above or from the world.
把这个社会的智慧带到教会里面，常常就在造成教会的扰乱。
And if they bring worldly wisdom to the church, it often brings confusion in the church.
那带来嫉妒纷争。
It will bring self-seeking and arguments.
然后十七节。
Verse 17.
上头来的智慧是清洁的、和平的、温良、柔顺、满有灵敏、多结善果、没有偏见、没有假冒。
17. But the wisdom that is from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without partiality and without hypocrisy.
所以这个约书亚、摩西按手之后，他被这个神的灵充满，就充满着智慧。
After Moses laid hand on Joshua, he's filled by the Spirit and filled by the wisdom from God.
所以今天我们要承受神的工作，需要从神领受这个智慧。
So today, when we inherit the work from God, we need to also inherit this wisdom.
所以通过我们的服事，不会带给教会混乱，不会带给教会纷争，不会带给教会嫉妒。
So through our work, we will not bring confusion, fight or envy within the church.
那通过我们的服事
that through our service,
带给教会和睦
that we're able to bring peace.
带给教会很多的善果
we can bring all the good fruits in the church.
对人有怜悯
and that we become very merciful towards people.
没有假冒，没有偏见
that we serve without partiality and without hypocrisy.
所以我们就知道说， 这个服事技巧上的训练哦，当然是几个小时就完了，但是在灵性上的栽培真的是需要一段时间。
So we know that in terms of skills in servitude, it can be learned in few hours, but the spirituality aspect it requires time.
那我们有了这个上头的智慧，我们对事情的回应，啊，会跟这个上头的智慧表现一样。
So when we have the wisdom from above, then in terms of the way that we deal with matters, it will be just as it recorded here from above.
会带给教会清洁、和平、温良、柔顺。
You will bring pureness, peacefulness, gentleness into the church.
但是如果我们对教会的问题的回应带给教会更混乱，很可能我们是用地上的智慧在做教会的事情。
But if the way we deal with matters that brings more confusion to the church, then most likely we are dealing with it using the wisdom of the world.
用血气在教会里面做事。
That we're using flesh to do the work of the church.
所以，承受使命的约书亚。
So Joshua, who inherited the ministry,
有神同在，充满上头的智慧。
He had the abundance of God, and he filled with the wisdom from above.
心中有圣灵。
He had a Holy Spirit in his heart.
以色列人听从他。
It's why the people of Israel heeded him.
这个就是我们要追求的一个很重要的目标。
And that is one of the most important goals that we had to pursue after.
那进了约书亚记以后，就开始实际上这个责任已经下来了。那下一步怎么做？
So into the book of Joshua, now he had taken over the responsibilities. What should he do?
那如果我们看约书亚记，看约书亚做的工作跟摩西做的工作就不一样。
So when we look at Joshua, we see that his work is different from the work of Moses.
摩西的工作是出埃及走旷野。
Moses' work is to lead them out of Egypt and walk in the desert.
约书亚的工作是跨过约旦河，然后得迦南。
The work of Joshua is cross over the river Jordan and to overtake the land of Canaan.
所以这个就让我们知道说，上一代在教会做的工作，可能它的重点跟我们下一代在教会做工作重点可能不一样。
So this tells us that the work from the previous generation, the key points might be different from the work in the later generations.
因为教会一直往前进嘛。
Because The church is always striving forward.
所以很多的工作它重点都不一样。
So the main points of different work will be different.
但是第一点要跨过约旦河。
But the first point is that we had to cross over the river Jordan.
好，我们先来看约书亚记第一章。
Let's turn to Joshua chapter 1.
约书亚记第一章。
Joshua chapter 1.
第三节，请读。
Verse 3. Every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given to you, as I said to Moses.
这个第三节用完成式。
So here is already the past tense that it's already accomplished.
你们脚掌所扎之地，我照着应许摩西的话，都赐给你了。
So all the soles of your foot will tread upon, I have given to you.
然后接下去就告诉他，第六节。
And then it continue on to say verse 6.
请读。
Be strong and of good courage, for to this people you shall divide as inheritance the land which I swore to their father to give them.
这个就前面要做的工作。
So this is the work that he's supposed to do beforehand.
所以这里可以看到神的应许跟人的努力。
So here we see the promise of God and the work that people do.
神的应许说我已经给你了，这已经完了。
So the promise of God is that I have already given to you, it is already accomplished.
但是人需要努力去凭信心跨越丹河去攻打那一块地。
But man has to strive and to work hard to cross over the Jordan and to fight the battles.
所以这可以看出来教会的发展这是神的应许。
So we had to, we can see from here that the development of the church is promise of God.
但是人需要努力。
But being people, we had to work hard.
也不是说神的应许，那就神自己做工，我们都不需要做什么。
we can just say it's the promise of God, then we don't have to do anything.
福音要传遍地极。
So the gospel has to preach to the end of the earth.
这是神的应许。
That's the promise of God.
但是保罗还是要需要三次的宣道旅程。
But Paul still needs to go through his three missionary journey.
这是人的努力。
This is the work of man.
那在人的努力之下，神的应许就实现了。
That after man had worked, then God's promise is fulfilled.
所以有时候这个教会的圣工不能发展，有时候是因为我们人的努力不够。
So sometimes when the church's work cannot develop, it is because we haven't worked hard enough.
这不是神没有应许，不是说这不是神的旨意，是我们投入不够。
And the reason that we don't do as well is not because God haven't promised or God hasn't worked.
好，第一个就是过约旦河。
So the first thing that had to do is cross over the land of Jordan.
那是怎么过去的
？How do they cross?
我们看第三章。
Let's read chapter 3.
在进入第三章之前，我们再回来看第一章。
Before chapter 3, let's read chapter 1 first.
第七节。
Chapter 1, verse 7. 7, only be strong and very courageous, that you may observe to do according to all the laws which Moses, my servant, commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right hand or to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go.
Okay, 再看第八节。
Also verse 8, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success.
第九节。
Verse 9, have I not commanded you, be strong and good courage, do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
在这三节圣经节里面，
So in these three Bible verses,
七节跟八节
verse 7 and 8,
说你无论往哪里去都可以顺利
that you can find success wherever you go.
那关键在哪里？
What is the key point?
我吩咐你的话，你都要遵守。
The word that I commanded you, you have to observe.
然后不可离开你的口，要昼夜思想。
And those words shall not depart from your mouth. You should meditate it day and night.
那这样，神就要与我们同在。
And in this way, God shall be with us.
凡事亨通。
Then we shall find success wherever we go.
所以这一点哈，就让我们看到我们现在这个教会哈，有所谓的规章细则败露。
So this tells us that sometimes we have bylaw problems.
当然，这个规章细则，第一个是应付政府的需要。
Of course, we have those bylaws in order to abide by the regulation of the government.
那第二个是我们有一个很简单的原则来指导我们的这个组织。
And the other point is that we have it so that we can have a simple principle to understand how we are organized.
但是，如果要让我们教会运转的很顺利。
But if we want to operate in the very smooth way,
要让神跟我们教会同在
to allow God to abide with the church,
最重要的关键还是神的话。
The most important point is still the word of God.
所以我们这个教会的重点不要放错了。
So we should not misplace the emphasis of the church.
有神同在，有神在带领，我们教会才会发展，才会顺利。
Only when God is with us, only when God guides us, then the church can grow.
但是要神同在，神带领，要遵守圣经的原则。
But if we want to have God abide us and guide us, we have to abide by the principle of the Bible.
所以不能够把掰漏看成比重要，圣经还重要。
So we cannot place bylaw before the Bible.
这只是给我们对政府的登记，对内有一个很简单的原则，一个指引。
So this is a direction that we should have in terms of the way we view it to outside and inside.
因为神的话，最后就是爱神爱人。
Because at the end, the summary of God's word is to love man and love God.
是有生命的。
it has life.
但是 bylaw 不是跟圣经是不一样。
But bylaw is different from the Bible.
所以我们需要它，但是关键还是在圣经。
It is needed, but the most important thing is still the Bible.
如果我们教会完全照 bylaw 来 run, 有时候这个教会会变公司。
So sometimes if we always go abide by the bylaw, sometimes the church will become a company.
那教会一旦用公司来管理，教会就没有生命了。
Once we operate the church as a corporation, then it doesn't have life.
所以 bylaw 需要，但是教会发展要回到圣经。
So we do need the bylaw, but when we want to grow the church, we must return to the Bible.
这个重点一定要抓对。
So we must grab onto the key points.
我们教会的方向才会正确。
Then our direction of the church can be correct.
我们就不会在旷野多绕四十年了。
Then we wouldn't be wandering in the desert for 40 years.
好，那跨过约旦河，等我看约书亚记三章。
So after we cross the Jordan River, let's read Joshua chapter 3.
第六节。
Verse 6.
从第四节开始。
Verse 4.Starting verse 4. Verse 4. Yet there shall be a space between you and it, about 2,000 cubits by measure. Do not come near it, that you may know the way by which you must go, for you have not passed this way before.
这个地方说，以色列百姓啊，要跨过约旦河啊，有一点就是要跟约柜离2000咒。
So one of the points that when the Israel crossed the Jordan, they had to have a space of 2,000 cubits in between the ark.
原因是使你们知道所当走的路。
So this is so that you may know the way you must go.
那这一条路你们没有走过。
Because this path you have not tried it before.
所以，这个我们教会的带领要。让神走在前面。
So when it comes to the guiding of the church, we need to have God walking before us.
有时候我们有计划。
Sometimes we have plans.
但是计划也有时候也可以改变。
But plans will change.
那这样啊，我们要留一个空间啊，给神来改变我们。
We need to leave a room for God to change us.
而不是说我们的计划都不能改。
We cannot say that our plan is unchangeable.
所以，在圣灵的带领之下，有时候我们计划一直在修改。
So sometimes under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, our plans always change.
好像福音传到欧洲去。
Just like when the gospel is preached to Europe.
保罗三次改变他的计划。
Paul changed his plans 3 times.
所以。我们在做计划里面要把神放进来。
So when we make our plans, we have to put God into the plan.
所以他们在过约旦河的时候，约柜要在前面。
So that's why when they cross over the Jordan River, the ark is before them.
好，那我们再看他们在攻爱城。
Now we also see how they overtake the city of Ai.
约书亚记第五章。
Joshua chapter 5.
十三节。
Verse 13.
这里啊，约书亚就看到有一个人。
Here Joshua saw a person.
手里有拔出来的刀。
There within him a sword that is strong.
第十四节。
Verse 14.
我要做耶和华军队的元帅。
He said, "I will be the commander of the army of the Lord."
所以在这已经看出来了，是神在征战，因为神在做他们的元帅。
So here we see that the Lord is battling for them because the God is fighting for them.
所以到第六章啊，为什么这么容易打胜仗
？So chapter 6, we see how come they won so easily.
因为第五章已经看出来，神已经来了，在做他们的元帅，在带领他们。
Because in chapter 5 we see God is here and God is their commander.
所以教会的事情到最后就是要神当王啊，把事情我们做不到的就可以解决。
So in all the matters of the church, God has to be the king, then He can solve anything that we cannot solve.
那在第六章开始
，starting from chapter six，
他们在攻约旦河，在攻耶利哥。
They are fighting against the city of Jericho.
这也是神的方法。
This is God's way.
我们刚刚所提过的这个方法，实在是简单到我们没有办法想象。
It's so simple to the point that it might be hard for us to believe.
所以有时候最复杂的问题，如果神要解决那个真的简单到就这样就结束了吗？就很简单了。
Sometimes the most complicated problem, when God solves it, we see that it's so simple.
所以大教会，教会最重要的整个教会的治理还是要有神的同在同工。
So in terms of managing the church, we need to have God's abidance.
好，那到了第七章，现在发生一个问题。
So until chapter seven, there was a problem.
就是败在爱城。
They failed. They were defeated in the city of Ai.
这么大的耶利哥打胜了。
They overcame such a large Jericho.
但是一个这么小的爱城，他被打败了。
But they were defeated in such a small Ai.
当然我们过去都把它一直看到，因为里面有一个亚干呐。
Before we always say that it is because there's someone called Achan.
但是这也是对的。
It is still right.
但是如果我们仔细看这个过程
，But if we see the whole process,
如果看第三节
，verse three, and they returned to Joshua and said to him, "Do not let all the people go up, but let about 2,000 or 3,000 men go up and attack Ai. Do not weary all the people there, for the people of Ai are few."
如果我们看第三节，神在哪里？没有神。
When we read verse 3, we do not see God. God is not here.
对，没有求告神，没有。
Have they asked God? They haven't.
耶利哥打胜以后
，After they defeated Jericho,
他们在看爱城。
When they saw the city of Ai,
不必上去，2,000-3,000人就能够打倒爱城。
So they thought that they don't have to have all the people go; just need 2,000 or 3,000.
他也没有求告神。
They also haven't asked God.
为什么
？How come?
因为前面的得胜让人有一种自信。
Because the victory beforehand gave them a sense of confidence.
那这种自信让人失去靠神的心。
And such a confidence, because they have such confidence, they did not rely upon God.
所以这个我们在教会里面，我们在服侍神当中常常需要很谨慎。
So when we are serving in the church, serving the congregation, we have to be very careful.
保罗上过第三层天。
Paul went up to the third heaven.
保罗用神迹奇事使外邦人顺服。
Paul submitted the Gentiles using miracles.
保罗从神启示很多的道理。
Paul received a lot of revelations from God.
但是保罗说：“我能夸什么
？”But Paul said, "What can I boast about?"
我夸就是夸我的软弱。
He said that I can only boast of my own inequities.
真的是不简单。
This is not easy.
因为懂得夸自己的软弱。
Because he knows how to boast about his inequities.
所以才会依靠神。
That's why he's able to rely upon God.
才会刚强。
That's why he is able to be strong.
所以我有时候我们在服侍神当中，把世界上的信心带到教会来。
Sometimes when we serve in the church, we brought the confidence in the world into church.
有的人讲话为什么这么有信心
？So sometimes we say, "How come this person has such a great faith?"
有时候真的好像是因为事业成功了。
Sometimes it could be that they are very successful in the career.
我在公司管理多少人，几千人、几百个人，那个教会只有200-300个，这算什么？
So、maybe they are able to manage 2,000 or 3,000 people in the company. In the church, it's only 200 or 300.
所以教会就是要这样才能复兴。
So they'll say the church needs to be prosperous. Then you have to do this, and that.
但是讲的跟圣经不太一样啊。
But then whatever they said is different from what the Bible said.
是从中世纪里面带进来的。
Because what their thoughts is from the world.
那没有依靠神的。这种复兴教会的方法，这个都是很危险的。
So if they do not rely upon God and try to revive the church, it's very dangerous.
我们看腓立比书。
Let's turn to the book of Philippians.
腓立比书的第三章。
Philippians chapter 3.
第四节。
Chapter 3 verse 4.Verse 4, though I also might have confidence in the flesh, if anyone else thinks he might have confidence in the flesh, I more so.
英文说 confidence of flesh, 从肉体来的信心。
So this is confidence in the flesh.
他说如果我要讲我有啊。
So he said, if I want to speak about confidence in the flesh, I have.
从第五章一直讲，讲到第五节，一直讲到第七节。
From verse 5 to 7.
这一些啊，现在在主耶稣里面都没有用了。
All the things that he had is not useful in the Lord.
所以我们看哦，《使徒行传》有两个工人。
So we see that in the book of Acts, there's two workers.
一个什么都没有。
One of them had nothing.
一个什么都有。
The other one had everything.
什么都没有就是彼得。
The one that had nothing is Peter.
人看他是无学的小民。
He is an unlearned.Normal person.
但是他要服侍神，就给他智慧，给他能力，给他恩赐。
But when he wanted to serve, God gave him wisdom, gave him blessings and abilities.
那一个是什么都有，保罗。
And the other person is who had everything, Paul.
那神就给他了解，有一些事情跟服侍神是没有关系的。
And God gave him an understanding that sometimes in the work of serving, Certain things are useless.
你在加玛利门下受教，这跟服侍神没有关系。
All the education you receive under Gamaliel is useless.
你工会的议员，这跟服侍神没有关系，这个一个一个把它消掉。
Being the member of Sanhedrin is useless. You have to take them all away.
你在律法上的义无可指摘，这个跟服侍神也没有关系。
And the righteousness you receive from observing the law.It's also unrelated to serving.
所以到最后，我们来服侍神就是靠神。
So at the end, when we serve God, it is by simply relying on God.
我们的信心是神给我们。
Our faith is given to us by God.
而不是从世界产生的信心带到教会里面，要为教会做什么。
So the confidence that we have is now from the world and take it to the church, seeing that what we can do for the church.
这是一个过程。
This is a process.
我们需要学习。
We had to learn.
所以我们对自己的软弱越能够了解，我们就会谦卑。
So the more we have understanding of our weaknesses, then the more we'll be humble.
那我们越就越会依靠神。
Then the more we will rely upon God.
所以万事互相效力。
So all things work for the good of those.
所以很多事情的发生，有时候会渐渐让我们成熟。
So a lot of things that happen around us, it is to mature us.
让我们了解在社会上工作跟在教会里面服侍神是很不一样的。
To allow us to understand serving in the world and serving the church is very different.
那我们能够改变。
That we have to transform.
然后我们才能够被神用。
Then later on, we can be used by God.
我们看罗马书。
Let's turn to the book of Romans, chapter 12.
罗马书十二章
，Romans chapter 12，
第一节跟第二节。
Chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. Verse 1, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind.That you may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
这第一节在讲要将身体献上当作活祭。
Verse 1 says we have to offer ourselves as living sacrifice.
这样的侍奉是理所当然的。
And this is a reasonable service.
那这个很好。
It's very good.
我们把这整个人要奉献服侍神。
We have to offer ourselves to serve God.
但第二节一样重要。
The second point is equally important.
所以第二节如果看英文 conform, transform, 你就是要 变两个选择。
So in the verse 2, we see there's two choices, either you conform or transform.
第一个就是被世界同化，用世界的做法、想法、观念带到教会来。
So the first way is you conform to the world and using the thoughts and methodologies of the world and bring it to the church.
这个是危险的。
This is dangerous.
那另外是 transform, 就是更新变化。
And the other way is transform and renewing.
哦，那我们能够了解神要我们怎么做。
And we seek out on what God wants us to do.
明白神的旨意。
To understand the will of God.
那用这样来服侍教会，这个就是教会啊得到造就的一个原因。
Then if we serve in this way, then the church, that would be the reason why the church is edified.
哦，所以啊，第一个我们要服侍神。
So first point, we want to serve God.
需要神在激励我们。
It has to be that God is motivating us.
第二个。
The second point.
我们心态。
Our attitude.
要从世界的同化当中变成在神里面的变化。
We have to escape from the conforming to the world and transform in God.
那这样我们就可以来承受教会托付我们的工作。
And only in this way we can inherit the work that's given to us.
把教会带到迦南地。
That we can bring the church into the land of Canaan.
让教会成为一块流奶与蜜，充满神的恩典、神的同在的一个地方。
And to make church to be a land flowing honey and milk, a land that is abided by God.
这样早上跟大家一起来学习这个题目。
So this is our morning study.
好，我们一起来祷告。
Let's all pray together to finish.
奉主耶稣的圣名祷告。